The College Council has elected the candidates under Section 92F of CPSC Ordinance to the fellowship and membership of the college. May I request the recipient of the fellowship and membership and the honorary fellows to rise and repeat the words of oath after me. Fellows and members and the honorary fellows from BCPS, please rise. In the name of Allah Almighty, I faithfully promise to maintain the traditions, the dignity, the standards, and the ethics of College of Physicians and Surgeons, Pakistan, that I shall devote myself to those medical activities which comes within the scope of my profession, that I shall follow those methods of prevention of disease, diagnosis and treatment which according to my ability and judgment are consistent with best evidence medical practice. In this endeavor, I shall always strive to do no harm. When in doubt, I shall seek the counsel of my colleagues. I shall willingly assist others in advanced knowledge in my specialty to the best of my ability. May Allah help me in this endeavor. Fellows and members, please remain standing. May I request the President, College of Physicians and Surgeons Pakistan, Professor Zafrullah Chaudhary, to admit them to the fellowship and membership of the College of Physicians and Surgeons Pakistan, President Professor Zafrullah Chaudhary.
Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. His Excellency Mian Muhammad Shahbaz Sharif, Chief Minister Punjab, Professor Mahmood Hassan, President Bangladesh College of Physicians and Surgeons, Professor Khaja Sadiq Hussain, the past President, respected delegates, Bangladesh College of Physicians and Surgeons, Vice Chancellors, Principals, and senior members of the faculties, my fellow counselors and fellows of the college, distinguished members of the medical profession, guests, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu Alaikum. It's a matter of great pleasure to welcome the Honorable Mian Muhammad Shahbaz Sharif, the Chief Minister of Punjab, to this august congregation of 46th CPSC convocation at Lahore, which makes the beginning of the Golden Jubilee celebrations, starting with Lahore, as well as in the rest of the country. Sir, I'm grateful to you for gracing this occasion despite your very busy schedule. I also wish to accord my warm welcome to the delegates of Bangladesh College of Physicians and Surgeons for their participation in Golden Jubilee celebrations, which could offer graduating doctors opportunity to acquire a credible postgraduate qualification within the country, thereby preventing the brain drain in medical profession, as well as to lay down a system of specialist care in the country. With this mission in mind, these 50 visionaries, people under this great man, the dedicated and dynamic leadership of Lieutenant General W.A. Barkey, the then Federal Minister for Health, persuaded the government to promulgate an ordinance granting charter for the College of Physicians and Surgeons of Pakistan on the 19th of February, the year 1962. Ladies and gentlemen, the college started its journey from the shabby barracks of Federal Drug Laboratories in Defence Area of Karachi. College of Physicians and Surgeons of Pakistan today stands prominently among the very few institutions of the country that have been able to accomplish their mission and have gained strength and vigor with the passage of each day, thanks to the vision of founding fathers, untiring efforts of the successive councils, and the commitment of the fellows that the college today enjoys the prestigious position of premier institution of postgraduate medical education, not only in the country, but also in the region and in the world. Now, with these three objectives, the evidence for this thing is how to do this thing. The college has prepared a indigenous, what you can see, the star, that is the Star National Residency Program of Pakistan. The unique thing about this star is that in this country, Pakistan throughout, there is a uniform one-time admission throughout the Pakistan in the accredited hospitals. The next is the curriculum. There is one curriculum for each subject which is run throughout the country, again from the north to the east. And then we have a harmonizing system of the training and the monitoring. And we always take a great pride in our system of examination, which is transparent, which is always participated in a fair number of people from abroad, and its authenticity and its credibility is being established over the last 50 years. In the country as well as abroad, this network right now is providing postgraduate training to more than 16,000 postgraduates under the capable supervision of more than 2,500 supervisors in 154 institutions of the country. Outside Pakistan, the network of the training includes institutions in Saudi Arabia, Nepal, UK, Ireland, USA, Singapore, and a few countries of Europe. It's not easy to stay in touch. Therefore, college has developed the technological usage. CPSP fully appreciates the role of technology both in learning and in governance. It has therefore invested heavily in information technology. As a result, the use of computers and internet is being made essential for training. You could see this network. Every postgraduate student of this college and every teacher or supervisor of the college has got the college ID and it has got the college password. And this has helped us in the training, in the examination and the office work, monitoring of huge network, and training has become more easy and meaningful when the introduction of e-log. Next thing I think you've always wanted, and college is prepared to strengthen the district headquarter hospitals and provide incentives to fellowship residents so that this huge resource could also be utilized for training as well as for the patient care in these hospitals so they can get a round-the-clock specialist cover and also help the government for planning in future and allocation of funds. Last but not the least, please involve the CPSP as a policy developing and advisory body on all issues related to health. I'm sure CPSP can help the government better as it has both experts in diverse fields with wide experience. Ladies and gentlemen, after these humble submissions, I would now like to focus upon today's convocation. In order to facilitate the graduating fellows and members, this year CPSP is holding 46 convocation in 4 cities instead of 2. Lahore, followed by Islamabad, then Peshawar, then Quetta and Karachi. In Lahore convocation, 423 fellowship and 53 memberships are being awarded, and I take this opportunity to congratulate the recipient of the CPSP qualification and much more congratulations to their families and spouses who have equally spent a very hard time in helping these young people become a future. And I expect from these young specialists of today that they shall, like their predecessor, play their vital role in the promotion of specialist care and education in the country. Ladies and gentlemen, before concluding, I wish to once again thank the Honorable Chief Minister for this, for his gracing this occasion, and you, ladies and gentlemen, for your participation. In the end, I apologize to you for taking a little extra time, but I've tried to cover up the 50 years. So therefore, I hope you'll forgive me. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.